Hey Leo!
Hi!
What are you doing?
Well, me? Transforming myself, obviously. Because where people normally see ki Sudha Chandran is always dressed to kill, her makeup is like a little overboard. So I really want my folks to know how this transformation actually happens.
Oh.
From a very simple Jane to that really overdecked, overdone makeup, which I thought in the beginning was a little too much for the audience, but I'm so happy that they accepted it and accepted it so well that it actually became a trend. So that's what I'm doing now.
Wow, so let's see, let's watch.
Yes, I think the eyes are very important in makeup. It's very important because you convey most of your emotions through your eyes, especially for me. My eyes work wonders. They work wonders in the sense, since I'm playing a negative character most of the time, I try to use my lips or my eyes. And they speak volumes. So that's why if you see my makeup, my eyes are always overdone. My lips are like, you know, deeply projected. Mm-hmm. So that, because especially in the scene that I'm doing Bepana Pyar, it is not very aggressive negative. It's a very smiling negative character. So you see, my eyes and my lips will always be enhanced. That is the secret. Don't drink. And I have to do a little bit of under eyes covering is because I have this issue of a little bit of dark circles and little bags under eyes, so which I normally work on a little just to cover it up. But I always believe in aging with grace and style, so I don't do much of it. I don't overdo things except my makeup. Well, I've almost finished my base and I am going on to do a little bit of the oily base needs a little bit of padding so that it doesn't leak out a much of oil on the face, keeps the face dry. So this is a small compact that I normally use after I almost done with my makeup. And if people keep asking me for this makeup, how much of time do you take? Do you take about 3 to 4 hours? And I say, no, just about half an hour. And since I have these lovely highlighted cheekbones, thanks to God, which I always considered my manufacturing defect. But I personally feel that when you enhance your cheeks, when you smile, it looks really pretty. So I do a little bit of my jawline. I have a little heavy jawline, so I normally cut it. And I'll show you how I do it. Well, I take a little darker shade to this is the dark shade that I use just to cut down on my this little projection that is there, which we feel many a time, you know, a double chin. It's not exactly a double chin though, but in television, since it's a very close-knit media, these things really need to be taken care of. So this is how I cut my jaw line. And it gives me a more clean, tighter, nice finish to the face, an oval shape, which is very beautiful for the television.
Okay.
Because it's very important how you shape your face also. It's the small things that we do.
So is it a particular base, this which you're using? This is actually only for cutting the...
Yes. Yeah. This is a little darker shade. It's a nice soft dark brown powder, which we normally use as contouring. Contouring is basically done to enhance your jawlines. See, I have a very flat nose, so I need to little, you know, enhance it so that it gives a more sharper look. But it should also not look very prominent. See, now it looks very prominent, but then I'll make sure that I diffuse it so that it doesn't look absolutely cut. And this is a lovely cheekbone. After you put your blush on, if you take a dab a little bit of this dark brown, it helps you to give that very this jawline. So these are small things which gives us very that chiseled features. And then finally what I do is I use a blush on which is normally a light brown or a golden with a little bit of shine on it. See, this is the one that I use, which is a little got a nice shine.
Yeah.
So once you use it and then blend it properly, it's very important whatever you use has to be blended very well, otherwise it looks very patchy. So this is how I blend my blush on. And even if I feel that it's a little heavy, like the character that I'm playing in Bepana doesn't need so much of heavy makeup. So what I do in the end is I use a nice shimmer, a cute little shimmer, which evens out your makeup. So what you do is, like, you take dab, just dab it, and go a little lighter, so that the blush on doesn't look very prominent, and your nose shade, which was looking a little dark in the beginning, actually tones down.
So you keep changing your blush on according to your clothes, color or something? Or is it like, okay, right now what you're doing is the base and then you'll add the costume color
also,
to it?
It also depends upon what character you are doing.
Okay.
When I'm doing an extra glam damn character, then I make sure that I match my eyeshadow, my blush on and my lipsticks. Otherwise, I try to keep it a little mute because it also matters. See, if you can't play a very nice, simple character and then overdo yourself, which at times may look a little garish, and there's also a lot of transformation in television makeup today. Gone are those days when we used to be very garish, we used to be very projected, but today with the HD coming in, very light makeup also enhances your beauty so well, and people's tastes have also changed. I mean, they don't like this garish makeup anymore, they like this very pleasant, nice, perfectly blended face. That's very important, is the perfect blending of your makeup. That's very important.
So now what's this?
This, I'm using my mascara, because after this I'll be using eyelashes, false eyelashes. Again, the false eyelashes depend on the character. Like here, I'll be using very light eyelashes, which is very nice and simple. But otherwise, the lashes that I use are a little heavy, depending on what character that I use. That I'm playing, but here what I'm going to be doing is, it's a very very, very light, see the difference between the two lashes. Now this is a lighter one and this is a heavier one.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, there are a lot of difference.
Yes.
So this normally you use is when you want to, you know, deepen your eyes, and you know, your eyelashes should look a little more louder, and this is when you're playing a nice simple character. So see, everything what you use is very important. You can't mismatch things, because then it will not set properly. So this is a little information that I want to give. And finally, what I do is, like, before you get your eyelashes fixed, it's very important that you stretch your eyelashes too with a mascara, which is very important. Otherwise, when you stick an artificial false eyelash, the false eyelash will look different and your personal eyelashes will be down. So once you take it up and then stick the false eyelash, it looks like one. That's very important. And normally what we do is, like, you also do the under eyes with an eyeshadow, but here I'm not using it, is because in Vipana I have kept the eye makeup very simple, very minimal, because I'm playing a buddy ma and very very positive in front of the family, though it's a negative character. So these are small things as an actor that you have to follow. You can't do the same type of makeup in every serial. So that's very, very important.